The Green Bay Packers were all about. They didn't do it for individual glory. They did it because they loved one another, once said Vince Lombardi. Not just one player can take you to the top. You need great team output to be successful. You need a complete defense for the players who stop their team from scoring, a fluid offense for the players who score for your team, and a solid special team score who can change the game at any given moment with a big kick return or block. You need to have the best players at their given position, but they also have to be able to work together very well if you want to win. They always say that defense wins championships, and that is very true. Without a good defense, you won't be able to stop any other teams, and if you expect to win any games in your season, you can't be giving up a lot of points. The first part of having a good defense is having a great defensive line. A great example of a great defensive line is the New York Football Giants. They have big name players like Justin Tuck, O.C. Manira, Jason Pierre-Paul, and Chris Canty, all who are high-caliber defensive linemen. Your defensive linemen have to be able to put a pass rush on opposing quarterbacks and also have to be able to stop opposing teams' running backs from making big plays. Another key part to a championship defense is a linebacking core. Linebackers are your meanest and most aggressive players. Usually your middle linebacker is like the quarterback for your defense, playing the role of team captain and signaling in the plays in and out to all the defensive players. To go along with the defensive line and linebackers, you also need defensive backs, whose primary job is to stop pass plays and cover the wide receivers. These players are usually smaller and very fast, with great hands to knock down the ball and to intercept it. Charles Woodson is a perfect example of a defensive back. He's always around the ball. He led the NFL in interceptions with 7 and is also an 8-time Pro Bowler. All three of those main parts of defense are essential to winning games and becoming a powerhouse. You also have to score points to win games, and that is where having a good offense comes into play. There are three main parts to a good offense: the offensive line, the quarterback, and other offensive backs such as wide receivers and running backs. Without an offensive line, nothing gets done. The offensive line has to be able to get defensive bodies moving on run plays and be able to create a pocket for the QB to sit in on pass plays. If blocking does not get done, the running back has nowhere to run and the quarterback has no time to throw, which can be very bad and will eventually make you lose games. Your QB is the leader of the team, both by how he plays and by how he communicates with the team. He also has to be able to throw the ball on a dime in between defenders and be able to run away if the pass protection breaks down. Aaron Rodgers is a great example of a quarterback that you would want on your team. He led his team to a playoff appearance the last 3 seasons. Along with a quarterback, you also need solid running backs and wide receivers. They need to be able to run with the ball to slow down the game, or to catch the ball for a big play and catch the defense off guard. These players can take lots of pressure off the quarterback if they do their job right. A team who has great offensive backs is the New Orleans Saints. Explosive players like Darren Sproles and Devery Henderson make it almost impossible for opposing teams to stop. The last key part of having a championship football team is special teams. This part of a football team consists of kickers and return teams. Great kickers have to be accurate and have range to be successful. The other part of special teams is the return teams. A big return or a big hit can be a crucial point in the game. If you can combine all three of the main parts of football, you will have a team to be messed with. Your defense, offense, and special teams all have to work together to win games, and they have to work better than everybody else if you want to take it to the next level. You might have noticed out of all the players I mentioned, there were 2 main teams that most of those players came from, the Green Bay Packers and the New York Giants. Those 2 teams are the last 2 teams from the NFC to win the Super Bowl. Getting there isn't just luck. It takes great players and great teamwork. You have to have everyone on the team working hard and believing. Not one player can be out of the loop, otherwise the whole ship sinks. A chain is only as strong as its weakest link.